In 1976, Parliament passed the Race Relations Act. One of its aims was to promote good relations between different ethnic groups. Multiculturalism. Diversity. It was law. We'd all get along as if we were warping space-time on the Starship Enterprise. 30 years later, the race policy is being stir-fried by ministers announcing that multiculturalism is not working. It's causing division, creating ghettos, and what's that word? Apartheid! Desi DNA have asked two people who care to put their view for and against multiculturalism. Writer Benjamin Zephaniah lives in Newham, an area where ethnic minorities outnumber whites. He's in favour of multiculturalism.
Multiculturalism is working. It's here and it's now. All this talk about the failure of multiculturalism is inspired by this so-called war on terrorism.
Broadcaster and academic Kenan Malik is a Londoner with a counterintuitive view. He's explaining why multiculturalism is wrong.
I'm an anti-racist. I always have been. That's why I hate multiculturalism.
Okay, boys, convince me.
Multiculturalism means a set of policies that undermines all that is good about diversity. Policies that put us into separate ethnic boxes. And it's created not a more equal Britain, but a more tribal one.
The opposite of multiculturalism is monoculturalism. Now that's what the French do, and look at their problems. And what is being British anyway? Let's try doing a citizenship test.
Fresh and nice!
When did women first get the same voting rights as men?
I ain't got a clue.
What is the name of the patron saint of Wales?
No idea.
Do you know who the Huguenots are?
Oh, the O?
Yeah, but they're all insignificant, aren't they, them questions? It's rubbish, you know what I mean?
Does that really, really tell you about life? No.
Yeah, but this is just opinion. How can you prove multiculturalism works or doesn't work?
In no area are multicultural policies more fashionable than in the arts. They're supposed to help people like Nerji Mahindru, a distinguished Asian playwright. So why does he loathe them?
Saris, samosas, that silly head movement thingy. That's the criteria of success in British theatre today. Multiculturalism has become a weight on our shoulders rather than a liberation. And from an artistic point of view, by definition, that is a problem.
This independent bookshop in Newham has been a cornerstone of the community for almost three decades. Customers demand that the bookshop stock books that reflect all ethnic groups, but yet no one ethnic group demands a section of their own.
When we've asked customers and said, well, look, should we just integrate these books into all the other sections? They go, no, we actually want books that talk about us. We support local authors or authors who may find it difficult to get published by mainstream publishers.
I thought multiculturalism was about people getting on, not supporting artists.
Multicultural policies treat minorities not as British citizens with the same hopes and aspirations as everyone else, but as semi-detached Britons who are interested only in their race or their faith. The results can be catastrophic.
One of the reasons radical Islam has taken a foothold is because multicultural policies have encouraged British Muslims to think of themselves as different. And in that kind of climate, it's not surprising that young British Muslims think of themselves at war with Britain, at odds with Britain.
Some people say that multiculturalism doesn't work institutionally or politically. But here in Ropley School in Newham, that notion has been completely disproved. This is multiculturalism working at a grassroots level. Forget all the focus groups, forget all those think tank thingies. This is where it really matters.
In some ways, multiculturalism is a good thing because it brings together a community. But people outside that community, it brings about fear.
I love to go to school in
in a place where there's loads of other different cultures, because it's like as if I've gone on holiday to all these different countries.
Yeah.
And then, you know, it's cheaper.
Yeah. Because if you talk to different people about their countries, you can really learn a lot.
I've heard both sides, but I'm still not sure. Closing arguments, please. Duplicate and then you wait
for the next Kuwait. I want to live in a world where I don't get attacked just because I'm Asian. That's why I hate racism. But I also want to live in a world where I don't have to act Asian, especially when someone else defines what it is to be Asian. That's why I hate multiculturalism. Multiculturalism imprisons us in ethnic boxes, creates conflict, and makes integration more difficult. We should celebrate diversity as lived experience, but reject multiculturalism as political policy.
Multiculturalism is happening. How can you stop it? Is someone going to stop Asian Dub Foundation from using reggae and rock samples? Are we going to ban the Bhangra? Is someone going to stop Sherry Blair from wearing a sari badly? Can you stop me from eating Chaniki Dal or Bindi? Nahi.
So, multiculturalism works as a lifestyle but not as a government policy. The question is, will they stop telling you what your identity is?